I think the originality of the film is really what's so unique about it. Right now, everything seems to be sequels and superheroes. And what's so exciting about Bullet Train is it's a big original entertainment, and yet it's really not, it's an original. And that's what's really so exciting about it. I think he's probably the premier action director working in Hollywood today. And Dave has a really an amazing balance of original big screen action and comedy. And you think about something like, you know, what he's done in the past with his films, he's really one of those filmmakers that knows what it means to put a movie on the big screen. So it's not a movie you should be seeing at home with this kind of action and the Japanese setting and the movie stars. So he's really the right guy to do big event action movies today, no question. I think the thing about Brad is that you don't see him do this very often. And so when he does, and you think back in his career, we worked with him last in Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, and he was so extraordinary in that film, and or maybe something like Mr. and Mrs. Smith years ago that he did, but this is really Brad doing what you people want to see him do. And, you know, he's also, he doesn't do that much. So when you get Brad, it's pretty exciting. There's some wonderful surprises that we're not going to reveal. Now you have to see the movie to see it. But when we read the script and there were all these wonderful little cameo roles and we started to dream about who we could get, the idea that Sandy Bullock or some of the other actors that appear in the film, movie stars also, all in the same movie was sort of just too delicious to ignore. I think movies have to be worthy of seeing in the cinema. And big screen entertainment is hard to come by, especially one that's not based on pre-existing IP. So I think we're really hoping that people embrace its originality, and it's and because it isn't yet another sequel and superhero movie, and that's what makes it special for the summer, certainly. What's interesting about this film in particular is that Aaron Taylor Johnson, we really was a discovery for us in this film, and now he's the lead of one of the most iconic Marvel characters playing Kraven. So that was a wonderful thing that we could find this actor who's a perfect Kraven to be in this film. And of course there'll be more Spider-Man, and there's the animated Spider-Man coming out. You know, we're being careful with these movies and taking our time with them, but contributing to our world of, you know, our Venomverse, if you will, our Spider-Verse.
In terms of the Venomverse, obviously fans are still racking their brains to figure out where exactly in the myriad of MCU timelines and places Tom and the rest of that world sits. Do you have a clear sort of vision of where that's going in terms of where we're going to see him and if he will ever get his own Spider-Man or perhaps reunite with one of our Fab Three?
Well, I think there's more stories to tell in the Venomverse. So, we've always had a plan for that film that would involve three different films. So we're on our way on that process, and there's a grand plan as well, and it's slowly taking shape, and we're excited that each one as it rolls out will begin to tell the story a bit more.
You talk a little bit about the unique reaction to Morbius and the social media phenomenon that the film has now become after it's been enjoyed on the big screen and the small screen as well.
I mean, Morbius, it was a fun movie to make because it really was a one-off, and where it's its own kind of unique story, this obscure character, Dr. Jekyll and Hyde, if you will, and Jared was, he sort of is a real-world vampire in a way, so it felt fitting that he would play that character. And the film, you know, has its like every movie, it has its detractors and it has its fans. But we've been quite fascinated by the interesting internet reaction to the film, and we're having a lot of fun, as is Jared with it, as you can probably tell from his relationship with the internet, you know.
We'll let you go. It's Morbin time. Thank you so much, Jared.